German Chancellor Angela Merkel is now heading to Poland for a momentous visit to the Auschwitz-Birkenau Nazi death camp. But critics accuse the Polish government of using Merkel's visit as a way to further distance Poland from Nazi war crimes.
Or to put it more simply, Poland largely rejects allegations of complicity in the Holocaust, and Merkel's arrival from Germany helps to shift that blame. And here now to discuss the situation is Ambassador Zvi Rav-Ner, former Israeli ambassador to Poland and Deputy Director General for Eastern Europe at the Israel Foreign Ministry. So our first question for you is, can you explain how the Polish people see their role in the Holocaust? Because it seems to be quite different from the way that the Jewish people view it.
Indeed, to an extent. It's true the Poles are trying, and especially in the last couple of years, are trying very hard to present themselves almost as equally as victims of the Holocaust, of the Second World War, as almost as much as the Jews. And there's a friction here and a discussion between us and them, indeed, on those matters. I don't know to what extent they have been using the visit of Angela Merkel there in Auschwitz, but definitely I've noticed that she was saying very clearly, and I'm sure that they were quite glad with that, that she insisted that those are not Polish death camps, those are Nazi German death camps. Mm-hmm. This is something that they very much were looking to.
So in your professional opinion, how revisionist maybe is Poland's view of their role in World War II?
Look, the Poles, there are issues that they are right about. Poland, it is true, Poland was the first victim of the Second World War on the 1st of September 39. They were the first nation to be attacked by the Germans, no doubt about it. And millions of Poles died throughout the Second World War. But there's, of course, nothing to do with the victimhood of the Jews. Wherever Poland was not the one who was really not responsible for the death camps, those were Nazi death camps. But what we are maintaining is that, unfortunately, not as an organized state, but as an occupied state, with several Poles who have been saving Jews, righteous among the nations,
sure.
The biggest number
of
righteous. However, so many, unfortunately, so many of the Polish people individually have been collaborating
right.
with the Nazis. And that's the problem. That's the difference of views between them and us.
All right, so now just speaking more specifically about Merkel, and I was shocked when I found out that this was the first time that she was going to be visiting Auschwitz. Why do you think that visit is taking place right now? Is that in the face of the rising anti-Semitism that we're seeing take place in Europe?
Well, she visited both Buchenwald and Dachau in Germany itself, and two of her predecessors, Schmidt in as early as 79, I think, and Chancellor Kohl in 89 and 95 visited Auschwitz. Mm. I don't know why it took 14 years for her to come and visit Auschwitz, indeed. But it's good. And
right.
what she said, what she has been saying there, these were good words, indeed.
Right.
She did refer to the, of course, to the Jews. One cannot refer to the very fact that out of 1.1 million people who were killed there, slaughtered there, gassed there, 1 million, more than 1 million were Jews. It's true
right.
that there were Poles
sure.
and there were Roma, there were Soviet prisoners, but Jews, this is the biggest Jewish graveyard on earth.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us and speaking to us about
this
matter.
Ambassador.